this process of thinking about a story and bringing it to life is actually a beautiful journey. Mundina Nildana happened like that, accidentally happened. I did this entire movie of 1 hour 46 minutes for the last 10 minutes. Kannada industry right now is one of the best places to be in because of the experimental content and because it's changing.
Vinay, welcome to Film Companion South. Your film Mundina Nildana released on 29 November and we are having this conversation right at the back of it. So thanks for your time.
Thank you. Absolute pleasure being on Film Companion South and talking to you. I've been following your work, commendable, and I'm super happy that you're representing Karnataka on Film Companion South. So congratulations too.
Thank you. Mundina Nildana itself is a film about the journey of three individuals and your journey itself has been very interesting, from an investment banker to television to films.
Yeah, quite a journey.
How's it been?
So it all started, I would call myself as an accidental filmmaker, because I never dreamt of making films in my life. Left India very early, very young, to pursue my masters. I did MBA from Wales, then worked for in the Indian Chamber in Singapore for about 2 years. I'm based out of Singapore. Got into banking. 11 years of banking career, have done many, many roles from investment banking to strategy to corporate, I mean, everything. I lost a very dear one to cancer about 5.5 years back. I came down and she was on ventilator in the ICU for about 54 days. And I was outside the ICU wanting her to kind of be okay. We were hoping that miracle happens and she would be okay, but unfortunately we couldn't save her. I went back as usual, life as usual, went back to work and things started becoming normal. But there was something that changed in me. I can't tell you what, KV, in terms of perspective of life, is that I was like, is this all life all about? What am I doing? What is happening? And two things that I learned about cancer is something that I wanted to spread. And that's the birth of me coming in front of camera to spread cancer awareness. So my Let's Talk with Vinay that I did, Matukate Vinay Jyote that I did, all was on health awareness and spread that message.
Until that tragedy happened in your life, you did not have any thoughts of being a filmmaker?
Absolutely no.
Okay.
Absolutely. Even then, no filmmaker. I just wanted to host shows to spread cancer awareness. And one show led to another. I was a YouTuber, making my shows on YouTube, getting the guests, you know, from Kiran Mazumdar Shaw to KL Rahul. I had amazing people come on my show and talk about the inspiring stories and spread awareness on cancer. Somebody saw that, put me in touch with a local Karnataka channel where I did a Kannada television. That was my television debut. I did not even expect in my dreams that I would be a television host. That happened. I was still working. I used to take 10 days off, airport to, you know, fly down to Bangalore, finish shoot, then quickly go back. I've done airport to office, take a shower in the office and go to work. I did all of that. Then somebody in Dubai saw that and gave me an opportunity to make my international debut as a host in Colors Hindi.
Okay.
So I did Salaam Namaste Singapore. So that's a show that I host every year in Singapore. That's a Southeast Asian show. That's when I decided that maybe I should kind of concentrate. I'm keeping my leg in both boats. It's not really good. And I started focusing on hosting. So Salaam happened. And then I did shows for Star Plus. The recent show that I did was Star Talk with Vinay, where I had amazing guests called South Meets North, of people who have come from South India and made an impression in Bollywood. So from Vidya Balan to Tabu to Rana to, you name it, Balki, Santosh Sivan. I had beautiful guests on my show. So I've done about 130 interviews so far and I've been sitting and listening to stories, inspiring stories, amazing personalities. Somewhere I think that got those experiences kind of grew on me, and a storyteller in me, he was always there, which I hadn't identified. Amir Khan's Sinistan contest happened in December 2015, where I saw this post. I'm like, why not I write a story and submit?
So by that time, had you quit your investment
bank? Yeah, taken a sabbatical.
Okay. Playing safe?
Yeah, I took a sabbatical and I'm like, okay, Vinay, I'm going to give myself 18 months time and see how is it going to go. I just wrote a story. And I submitted the story to the contest and nothing happened. I was hoping that, you know, I'm going to get a chance and all that. Nothing of that sort happened. Then I got an opportunity to make an advertisement short film for a brand in Bangalore. That's when I don't know what KV that I had in me, the audacity or the bluntness or the braveness. I told the client that I'll do it and I'm going to direct it. I didn't know the D of direction. I've never been to a film school. I've never assisted anybody. I just wanted to pick up that project. I was like, what's the downside? I'm going to make the short film. There is a budget for it. If it's going to be horrible, the client is going to ask the money back. Mm. And I'll pay it. I'm okay to do that. And I went, jumped into the ocean. And first, I mean, look at the audacity. I casted one of the most versatile actresses of Kannada industry, Sudharani, who's been in the industry for 30 years and amazing actor. So the first time I ever said action was to her.
Wow.
And I did that. Client approved. They liked it. You know, there's some dilly-dallying, but they liked it. I was like, not bad. You know, this process of thinking about a story and bringing it to life is actually a beautiful journey. And I was like, maybe I should explore. I would always say there was destiny behind everything that happened in my life, because everything was an accident. One thing led to another. Short films happened. I accidentally got into making music videos. I accidentally got into making documentaries. I did a documentary for Akshay Patra. Manish Malhotra was visiting Singapore with Kareena Kapoor for a fashion show for the first time, and star asked me to make a documentary on that. Hmm. So it was all right time at the right place and with the right opportunity. And what I did was, I'm the kind of person, when I did my strengths finder in my corporate life, one of the top three was a go-getter. So I'm okay to take risks, I'm okay to fail, but I'm okay not to try. So I'm that kind of a person. So I tried. I'm like, what is the risk? Am I going to fail? What is the, you know, what is going to happen? So with that mindset, I kept moving. And when I got an opportunity, when I wrote the story last year, January, when I got the producers on board to make this film, that's when I thought, when are you going to get one chance? You are going to be part of the Indian cinema. And you're going to make movies after this or not, it doesn't matter. But your name will be etched as a filmmaker. And one film that you're going to do will be a part of the Indian cinema. Because, you know, and Indian cinema is one of the biggest businesses in the world. The kind of movies that we churn out is so high.
And the volume and as well.
The volume as well. The audiences are very, very mature and very different. And culturally, we are so different. And I was getting to make a movie in my mother tongue, which is Kannada. And it was home ground for me. I was like, what better can I ask for? So Mundina Nildana happened like that. Accidentally happened. And then today we are sitting right after 18 months where I wrote my story, did the pre-production, and it's just released, and extremely happy that it's running. It's been very successful. So God's blessings.
Right. As you put it, right, there have been sweet accidents one after the other. And, you know, that's been your journey. But there's got to be something in you, right, that made these accidents as successful outcomes, right? And then you said you're a go-getter, right? Is that what, like, opportunities don't just come like that to everyone, but then you're saying opportunities came my way. What in you was important in capitalizing on those opportunities?
One, I don't take anything lightly. Now when you ask me this question, I'm dissecting that in my head. I'm trying to understand what did actually make me get opportunities one after the other. One is probably the respect and dedication that I have for my work, be it in my corporate or my short films or my hosting or my movie. I always want to treat it with utmost respect, and I invest myself in that.
Sure.
That is one. And second thing is, I think, KV, one thing that is very important, I'm telling this to you out of experience after making one movie, it's people management.
Mm.
Irrespective of whether you're a host, you're a filmmaker, you're a documentary maker, doesn't matter, it's about people management. And somewhere that 11 years of strong corporate background, managing people, and I got an opportunity to start my career with multiracial people, you know, because I'm based out of Singapore, I work with all kinds of people there. So that kind of gave me that very strong people management skills, interpersonal skills. That is something that I implement into my industry here.
This ad film that you're talking about, was it in 2016-ish?
It was in 2016, yeah. It was on organ donation called The Giving.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, very novice with direction in 2016, and in 2019 your film releases, right? And you would have been hit with so many surprises about this entire craft called filmmaking, right? Which was the biggest one that took you by surprise and, you know, kind of you left you unsettled, and then you thought, okay, this is serious.
Yeah. The first time I did my short film, I did not know how to take one scene to another. I had written scenes, I had written the story. It was a nice story. And I had moments. How am I going to stitch it as a filmmaker? Because I've never studied filmmaking. When I look at my short film now, it's blackouts. one scene finishes and there is a blackout and another scene comes. I did not know the technicalities and the craft of how to weave a story. My second short film I did, I learned on that and implemented that, but I did not know the importance of sound. I learned that on that. When I did the documentary, I realized the importance of the screenplay, of how we are going to stage. So I think somewhere, everything has taught me something, and I'm sure it's a learning on the way. Throughout my life, if I keep making movies, I'll keep learning on every movie. But if Mundina Nildana had happened 2 years before, I don't think so the product would have been like this. I think those experiences really molded me as a whatever filmmaker that I am today. And when I look at my work probably 2 years later, I'll be like, what have I done? It'll always be there with me. I'm never satisfied when I look at my work. But to answer your question, I think it is the learnings that I had on that which helped me to implement, and those technicalities, because at the end of the day, movie making is, story is very important, screenplay is very important, and technically stitching that is also very important.
In a way, it's very befitting that you call your film Mundina Nildana, because you've been talking about journey and you know how you've evolved and all of that, right? So tell me about the writing process of this film. What was the seed of this film, and what kind of provided you that impetus to start off with this?
As you very rightfully said, Mundina Nildana, when the name was coined, when we decided to have this name, my only thing...
So the title was already there?
The story was there. We were looking for a title.
Okay.
Hudukata was there.
Okay.
There were a lot of titles that we kind of coined around. But Mundina Nildana, when the title came, I felt it was absolutely apt for the story. Because one, I wanted to do something which is different from what is already there in the Kannada industry. I'm okay to kind of experiment. I was okay in terms of doing something which is not the norm. But what I really wanted was to do something different. That I always had in mind. But what I personally, when I looked at Mundina Nildana, the story, the seed that you asked me for is, I did this entire movie of 1 hour 46 minutes for the last 10 minutes. My movie is last 10 minutes. What you get out of last 10 minutes is what I want to tell people. I want people to take back. I want people to feel, and I want people to experience. So keeping that, I ask myself, what is that one liner I want to tell?
Sure.
Mundina Nildana is about journey. It's about moving on. In my movie, the characters move from one place to another emotionally. Characters change. People change. People get experiences. So I wanted that to kind of translate into something for the viewer who come and sit and watch the movie without being preachy, a commercially packaged, but a sensible story.
So what I actually felt was very interesting in your writing was that you don't try to explain your characters to the audience, right? You at the risk of them being judged by the audience, you just let it be like that.
In person also, I'm like that. I hate to explain myself to the loved ones. They know me that I'm a person that I'll just do the actions and I'll leave it for them to understand me or not understand me. Likewise, my characters also, they are as gray as me, as wrong as me. There's no right or wrong, they say. It's all perceptions. So my three characters, when I wrote, I did the one thing I diligently and consciously wanted to do was not justify their act. Why should I justify it? If somebody is marrying, why should I justify? If somebody is not marrying, why should I justify? It's the person's choice, it's the person's decision at that point in time, depending on his situations. Who are we to judge them? You see, in real life, when you look around, I think that society is already judgmental. So why do you want a judgment even in the movies?
Why Kannada? See, based out of Singapore, having had, let's say, Mumbai / Bollywood experience, sure, Kannada is your mother tongue, but perhaps this film would have suited any other language also
it's a universal
equally
story.
Well and probably better. So why Kannada?
When I submitted my story to Sinistan, it was a English story but for a Malayalam film. Though I don't know the language, I was like, Malayalam is great content movie, so I want to make a movie in Malayalam. And the story was a very different story. So I started off with that thought process telling that I want content. And whichever industry accepts that, I want to make a movie in that industry.
Okay.
But then, when I looked at the last 3 years, 4 years of Kannada industry, the kind of movies that is coming up, I understand it's far and few. Commercial successes of offbeat cinema is far and few. But the attempt that the filmmakers are making, the chances that the viewers are giving for such films is slowly increasing. And I was like, this is a wave that you need to ride. This is something that my boss used to always say in corporate, and I'm sure you'll connect with it. You have 20 performers and you're one of them. Your pie in the cake is very less.
Right.
And you're two performers and you're one of them. Your pie is much larger. So I wanted a larger pie, and that pie, I don't know in what way it's going to come. Is it going to be a name as a filmmaker? Is it going to be commercial success? Is it going to be critical acclaim? I don't know what is it. But I knew that Kannada industry, if I try and do something different, then there are people who will accept. There are people who will remember it for a long, long time. And that was a start. And again, as you said, my mother tongue, it's home ground for me. And I've grown up in Bangalore. And this is a story that happens in Bangalore,
right,
of three people who are in Bangalore. So for me, I felt very safe. I felt like I can go wrong, it's okay. You know, I'm not an outsider, that perspective. So right, that's why Kannada.
This is, let's say, not a very regular theme in Kannada, right? So what did it take for you to convince the producers, one? And also, why don't you, you know, share a little bit about what the journey has been after having made the film, but from post-production to release? That in itself is a different journey altogether.
Absolutely, KV. You asked the right question, because I've been dying to shout out and tell all filmmakers who want to come into the industry, because people do not have a complete 360 degree perspective. All they want to do is, I have a story and I want to make a film. It's beyond that.
Right.
Movie making is 30% of the entire process. Just 30%. Creative ability, your creativity is probably 40% in your entire skill set that is required. Movie making requires much, much more than that. When I wrote Mundina Nildana, the story evolved with me for about 8 months. Gave a lot of time for the story to evolve before we locked in. My producers, Murli Shesh, Tara and Doc, there were four producers, first-time producers, came up with Coastal Breeze Productions, that's the production house. But what was really good is they all came with the same mindset in terms of making something different and new for Kannada. If that wavelength did not match, I don't think so, it would have been such a smooth journey for me. So point one I would like to say all young filmmakers is, when you have investors on board, make sure they're investing for the right reason. Because if they're coming in for money, tell them it might be either 0 or 100 crore.
Mm.
The range is really long. If they're okay to lose everything, then come inside. Not come for the wrong reasons. It's not an industry where you can come and take advantage. It is an industry where people are actually working and making a living out of.
Right.
Number two that I learned a lot is, your pre-production is the most important foundation and pillar. Do not rush into making a film just because you have a script. Everything in a movie tells a story. Your location tells a story, your costumes tell a story, your look tells a story, your art tells a story. So do not compromise before making your film. Your producers, number two, pre-production. Filmmaking is the easiest, KV. Actually, the process of making a film, if your pre-production is good, is easy. Your post-production. Your product is made in your post-production.
Right.
You can make or break. Your sound, your color, your edit will define your film. Lastly, even if you make a fantastic movie, even if you complete a film, it does not matter. There are about 300 odd movies in Karnataka sitting in the chamber without releasing. Releasing a movie is the utmost crucial thing. Marketing and distribution is the most, most, most important thing. Because at the end of the day, KV, this is a business.
Right.
People put money here. It's not like you want to, if somebody has a money or somebody has a creativity in them, they can put in the money from their pocket and make a movie for their family and friends. But here you have investors investing.
Right.
Their money needs to be, you know, it's a commerce at the end of the day. So make sure, as a filmmaker, you are there throughout the process. Understand how are you going to sell the film. Understand how are you going to market the film. How are you going to distribute the film? How is my producers going to get the money back? If you think that your job is just to make a product in the center and walk away, then you're going to probably not in the right industry. So I would say to all the young filmmakers that, apart from creativity, get to the whole process. It's an end-to-end thing.
So the approach that, hey, I'll concentrate on the craft and then I'll hire someone who can do all of this, would that work?
The person whom you're going to hire is somebody who can do justice to your product, who understands who is your target audience. Because at the end of the day, you might have made a movie for housewives. And if the person is marketing in a college, it's not going to fit.
Right.
So it is, as a filmmaker, you understand the entire tone, target audience very well. So I personally feel even though you have the right set of people working for you on that, you still need to oversee that. You still need to make sure that your movie reaches the right audience. So great if you get somebody who can do that for you, but I would say be hands-on as a filmmaker.
Now, your film also has very interesting collaboration of artists, right from Shah Rukh Khan's Red Chilies to you know, Jim Satya doing the background score, to Masala Coffee doing a song, and to Gully Boy's Pixel Digital Studio. Although it's a Kannada film, yeah. You got artists from across the country. One, it looks like you're very well connected, and two, so tell us how you got that network done for you, and two, also tell us why did you want to get all of these artists, and you had a surprise of A.R. Rahman tweeting about
your film. Yeah, tell me about it. So to answer your first question, I was very clear that a movie that I'm going to make should be based on what I would like to see, the vision that I have seen. The first thing on this plate for my vision was my cinematographer, because your cinematographer is your eyes. What I think in my head, if your cinematographer doesn't bring it to light, your coloring, your sound, your music, nothing can help. And Abhimanyu Sadanandan is my cinematographer, who he and I started our journeys together. Mm-hmm. From my Let's Talk with, first ever time I faced my camera was to him.
Okay.
So both of us have had a long journey in this entertainment industry, have seen a lot of ups and downs, and together we started doing Mundina Nildana. I completely trust him that if he knows exactly what I want. It started with that. And then it was picking in the rest of the people to kind of come along and do that. Red Chilli is why, because I always look at movies, right, as a commoner as well. When I see, I'm a designer, I design clothes. So I have an eye for colors. I have an eye for outfits and styles and designs and stuff. Somewhere that helped me, and when I look at a movie on a big screen, I'm like, wow, these color tones are really good. You know, when I used to see as a viewer, I used to enjoy that. So why not have that in my film? Mm-hmm. One of my producers is very close friends with somebody in Bombay. Prashant is his name. He's from Dharma Productions. And the connect started with that. So it was about seeking out and asking for references and, hey, can you connect me with somebody? I'm looking for this particular job position for my movie. Who can actually come and fill that? Who can actually do that? It started with that. It's more hunger to get the best of the people to do the best of the job. It started with that, and then Mundina Nildana shaped up with these amazing, amazing technicians. And I always wanted to be like, when I, you know, I live outside India, I meet different races, and I always like, I'm from, you know, when I say I'm a Kannadiga, I'm from Bangalore. When I recommend movies, I still go back to Amrita Varshini and, you know, America, and things like that. So I was like, why not have something that I can recommend, or somebody can recommend and say, you know what, you can watch this movie, it's a Kannada film. And they feel really nice about it. Like Ulidavaru Kandante, I love it, I recommend that to people. So that was the urge. So it was an urge to get the best technical product. It was an urge to represent my industry with something really good. And it was an amazing connect with the people whom I've met, my producers and the guests that I've had on my shows in the past. Everybody who have come in my life have played a huge role in terms of getting to this beautiful ensemble technical team.
I think it's a pertinent question now to ask you about safety at workplace, right? You have two lead ladies, and then why don't you tell me about how it's looked at in the industry in general and in Kannada industry in specific?
Yeah. If you observe, at the beginning credits of my movie, I was very particular to have a slide which says, on the sets of Mundina Nildana, nobody was sexually harassed, or there was something which said that there was workplace safety. Mm. Because I come from a corporate background, we have HR who takes care of us. In the entertainment industry, there is no HR. Mm. There is nobody to guard you. You're on your own. You might have a manager, but that doesn't matter. So, and also young filmmakers, young technicians like me and my team, when we're coming into the industry, we are coming here to make a change. And change starts from a person. You know, saying no to something is in your hands. I always believe, KV, that people have spoken a lot about, you know, hashtag Me Too. People have come out and voiced out. People have been called out. People have been punished and all that. I would say that's there in every industry.
Right.
It's the power that plays. It's the power play. It's about who has an upper hand. And what is at stake? How desperate is this person? And how much power does this person have? It's all the correlation between these two that a Me Too gets born. So if power is not misused, there's nothing. If you're not desperate or if you don't know the reason why you're in the industry, it's a problem. So I would really, really advise all young boys and girls, because the problem is same for all. Me Too is there in every industry, but entertainment industry is blown out of proportion because we are in the public eye. There is cameras everywhere. Headlines is always, you know, paper, news will always want to cover something which is juicy. There is TRP, there is viewership, and that's the reason why it happens. But what I would like to tell young actors, actresses, technicians, be sure in terms of why you're entering the industry. It is absolutely okay to compromise. I do not have any problem with people who actually do that. It is their choice. We have to respect that. But do not compromise if you don't want to.
So through this film, you had this opportunity to work with people, artists from different other industries, right? Other language industries. What is their perception of Kannada films?
Wow. So I had a very interesting conversation with somebody at Red Chilli's office. Their impression about Kannada films was that it's a tad bit louder. The sound needs to be a little more decibels. Brightness is a little more, you know, colors are a little more brighter and stuff like that. But the impression that
that's what they were doing to your product.
That's what they were trying to do for my product.
Because it was a Kannada film.
I was like, don't. Do not do that. Because this is a movie, this is a story that we want to tell. Irrespective of what language is it, there is a tone for the movie. And let's stick to the tone. It's a soft, gentle slice of life story. So let's treat the sound and the colors also soft, gentle slice of life kind of a thing. That was one. And another very, very interesting and something that I feel really proud of is that every industry has a cycle. You know, Kannada industry was one of the best industries in the 80s
right.
or 70s. I've seen from people like Anil Kapoor and Mani Ratnam, you know, making their debut in the industry. We had great legends like Dr. Rajkumar, Vishnuvardhan and Shankar Nag doing some phenomenal work. Directors like Puttana Kangal who had done path-breaking content. And then every industry has its cycle. Now what is good is it's going up. Now content is becoming more progressive. Filmmakers are experimenting, trying to put content first before everything else. So I think I'm very lucky to be at the time where the industry is going on a wave, where I can ride that wave and try to contribute something to the Kannada industry, where tomorrow after 10 years down the lane, when I look back in the last decade, you know, Film Companion did the top 25 movies or, you know, that was aspirational for me. You know, I want one of my movies to be there in that list, if not all. So Kannada industry right now is one of the best places to be in because of the experimental content and because it's changing. The saturation is not there yet.
So I watched your film and I for sure like the honesty in it.
Thank you.
And I hope it really does very well at the box office.
Need all the wishes. This conversation is in English because not because both of us cannot speak Kannada, because we want to uphold our product that's made out of Karnataka to pan India audience. So guys, don't comment. I know Kairam's videos get comments at the bottom telling that why you're not talking in Kannada. The reason is we want people beyond Karnataka to listen to what the guests that he's going to have on the show, and the work needs to reach more and more people, right? That's the whole intention.
Absolutely.
And so thank you for giving me an opportunity. I'm very, very excited, and thank you to Film Companion South and to you.
Pleasure is all ours. Thank you.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Vinay Bharadwaj, director of the movie Mundina Nildana. Film Companion has had a huge impact on my life because the conversations that I've seen on it has shaped me up as a filmmaker and as an individual. So Anupama Chopra, I've literally grown up watching your interviews. And today I'm extremely happy to have been on Film Companion South. If you've liked this conversation, please do not forget to like, share and subscribe.